praise our hands, oh Lord. Hallelujah. Yes. You're with us tonight. You give life.
You give life.
You are love.
You are love.
You bring light to the darkness.
You bring light to the darkness. You
restore. You restore.
You restore. Every heart that is broken.
Thank you.
us a turn. Ever read a story and you couldn't wait to get to the end and you said, man, remember that last few paragraphs? I'm like, I don't want to stop reading. I just want to savor this. I don't want to hear about what happened at the end. Amen. I read the back of the book right before the maps. You know what it says? It said the apostolic people win.
Yeah.
Amen.
It didn't say the Trinitarians win. It didn't say no certain church. It said the Jesus name apostolic.
Amen.
So if you're a winner, then I raise your hand.
Amen.
Amen. No matter what the weapon is, I want you to know that I win.
If I don't die, I will be. I obey.
Lord give us. Amen. I was on the phone several times with Brother Tony Spell yesterday and this morning, and just encouraging him and strengthening Tony. We were with him, and they said they were going to arrest him. And he had church, and they said, "No, we're not going to do anything. We're going to let them do what they want to do."
Amen. Woo!
Woo! Amen. Amen. Amen.
We talked to Sister Sissy on the way to almost most of the way to church tonight, and she's doing good, doing excellent. So we want, of course, her to continue. We want her to heal. Got Candace there, bunged up. We want to remember her, and also little Zach Walter. Where's he at? Is he? Where are you at, Zachary?
Right over here.
Over here.
Behind you.
Come up here by me. You can make it up here. This little guy has been diagnosed with lupus.
Oh.
And we've known he's been sick for a while. Jesus. He loves Brother Parker. He likes to get right down in front of the church building and make sure I'm watching him.
Yeah.
Him, come with some of his buddies, Levi. We love you, Zach.
Yes.
We're going to pray for you.
Yes.
Those who feel like you can come.
Yes.
Thank you, God.
Start the offering. Come down here. Going to lay hands on him and pray for him. If you don't feel comfortable doing that, then just stay where you're at. But those that do, come down and pray with me for Zach. Okay? All right, so we want to remember this coronavirus. We want the Lord to just keep it away from our church. And we want revival, and we're excited about the revival that we're having. Also, Sister Vicki Teamy has been sick for a long time. And one of our saints, she's here from the very beginning. So, remember Sister Teamy, and one more, Sister Geraldine Medders. That's Brother Medders' mom. And sang in our church, and blessed our church, and gave us Angelo. That's awesome.
That's
amen.
Right.
So, I want to remember her, that God touched her. She also has COVID-19.
Yeah.
And I think she's near 100 years old, isn't she? 90. So, remember her.
Amen.
And anybody else, just raise your hand and call it out to God.
Yes.
Let your request be known unto God. Father, we love you. We thank you for your goodness, Lord. We thank you for the mercy of God that's upon us.
Strength tonight.
We thank you for
God,
a great
give us
church.
Faith to believe in all that you do, all that you're going to do.
We're thankful.
Thank you for truth, Lord God. Thank you for truth. I love you, Jesus. I love
you. Thank you for the Holy Ghost.
Yes, bless our service tonight.
Thank you in Jesus' name. And everybody said
amen.
Yeah, guys, pass the buckets around. They'll come around.
Almighty God, I love
you,
Lord God, I love
you,
Lord God.
And you can be seated if you want. Come and pray with me for that.
I love you, Lord God, I love you, Lord God.
Bless the Lord with me.
Elders. for my bishop, the work they have to do here.
Yeah.
Even young people, young couples, or everybody else, say, I'm retired.
Yeah.
Retired from what? Leaving for God?
Yeah.
Tell it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Burned out from what? Leaving for God?
Yeah.
Come on.
If you're burned out right now, there's one more coming at the end. That would be going to be worse.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or, no, it's not my time yet.
Yeah.
Their time. Or my parents are representing us.
Oh, good.
Yeah. Think about it.
Good preacher.
These are the last days.
Mm-hmm.
It's, yeah. it's about time for us to live for God seriously.
Yeah,
that's right.
We have to refire up.
Woo.
Woo. Refocus.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Get loose.
Yeah.
Fight the devil.
Yeah.
Stay on fire.
Yeah.
Focus on our mission.
Yeah.
No matter what, we will win.
Right.
When we get out of this homestay, which means stay home, stay fight. We're going to be stronger and take this church to another level.
Yes.
Right.
And if you are not on board, you need to get on board.
Yeah.
Right.
The church will move on with you or without
yeah.
you.
Amen.
We have a mission to do. Reach, love, and serve. We got to reach, share what we have.
Right.
We got to preach the gospel. Reach the lost. We got to love the people. Love God with all heart and soul and mind.
Yeah.
So we can love our neighbors as ourselves.
Yeah.
Amen.
We got to love this city so we can reach this city.
Amen.
And we got to serve this city.
Right.
We got to serve this city with love. We help the community. There's lots of things going on in our church. And we need everybody's help.
Right.
Let your light shine so they can see your good works.
Yeah.
Or his good works on us. I don't want my blessing to become a curse on myself.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I want what God gave it to be shared to people. Well, James 4:17 says that, therefore, again, because of what you know, because of what we know, therefore, to him that knoweth to do good and do it not, to him it's a sin.
Right.
That's right.
It's in the Bible. And when we stay away or think about leaving these things of what we have, it's a sin. But I come to encourage everybody. I love you guys. Encourage everybody that this church, this revival is ours.
Yeah.
And for those of you that are listening, those of you that are watching, those of you that are not baptized yet, we have a baptismal tank.
Yeah.
Right. Amen.
You don't know when God's coming back.
Amen.
Yeah.
It's either tonight or tomorrow. You're going to be saved.
Yes.
Yeah.
If you're looking for salvation, this is it.
Yes.
Hope, this is it.
Right.
Answers, this is it.
Yes.
Power to overcome, this is it.
Yeah.
Yes.
Comfort, this is it. Deliverance, this is it.
Amen.
Let's stand. Let's call his name.
Jesus.
You can be seated if you shout unto God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
This afternoon, this morning when the preacher was going on, I said, Lord, I hope there's a cloud tonight that I don't have to squint the whole time. And look what he's done.
Amen.
And there's no wind.
Yeah.
I don't have to worry about my notes flying around. But I'm excited about living for God.
Yeah.
I'm excited about living in this day and age.
Yeah.
I'm excited about what's going on in our world. I'm excited what's happening in my family.
Yeah.
I'm excited that my brother's here at church tonight.
Yeah.
I'm excited about all those people, those backsliders that will be here soon.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's a great revival in this city for backsliders.
Yeah.
I believe God's going to bring them back because God's using this to get a hold of their minds.
Yeah.
You ought to just pray that way at home and start praying for those people that used to be here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I believe God's going to bring them back.
Yep.
I'm excited about it. I don't have to remind you again tonight and let you know that we have an adversary.
Yeah.
The Bible says he's like a roaring lion walking about seeking whom he may devour. That's the devil. He's the enemy of our soul. He wants to get us tripped up. Pornography's on the rise.
Yeah.
Why do I know this? Because the Bible says that
He knows his time is short.
Yeah.
So he's going to increase his messing around with us.
Yep.
Yeah.
What the men of our homes have to realize is that the devil is coming against your kids.
Oh, yeah.
Stronger than he's ever come against them.
Oh, yeah.
He's coming against them, and he's using their phones to do it.
Yeah.
We got them all sitting over here, so I might as well preach to them.
Yeah.
But your phone will get you into trouble.
Yeah.
And that devil's going to use it.
Yep.
And he's going to use it all the time.
Yeah.
All day, all night.
Yeah.
I don't have to be a prophet to know that, because I know there's temptation, but if he's coming down in great wrath, it's just going to ramp it up.
Yeah.
He wants to destroy every single one of your souls.
Yeah.
He wants you carrying babies around at 16.
Yeah. Yeah.
He wants you messing up. He wants fornication running rampant.
Yeah.
We heard this morning the preaching, there's a lot of temptation.
Yeah.
And we know where it comes from.
Yeah.
And really, we're defenseless. Mm-hmm. But we serve somebody who is not defenseless.
Yeah.
We serve an awesome God.
Yep.
The reason why I chose this text scripture, because I want to focus on this last son that Leah had. She named him Judah. And she said, now will I praise the Lord. The meaning of Judah is praise.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
The literal meaning of the word Judah is praise.
Yeah.
She said, I'll praise the Lord. Now listen to this in Genesis chapter number 49. Don't worry, this is going to get a lot better. I hope you brought your shouting shoes. I thought, I need to get some carpet and bring it down here so when people get to shouting, they don't get their knees all skinned up on the asphalt. But we got some grass over here.
Yeah.
Did anybody come to shout tonight?
Yeah.
It seems like there's some people that really want to express their emotion, but they're holding back just a little bit.
Yeah.
It shouldn't be that way.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, we're out here in the middle of this parking lot where everybody can see us.
Yeah.
You might as well shout.
Yeah.
Did you know that ever since I was a little kid that I've always heard preachers preach about shouting?
Yeah.
Ever since I was a little kid.
Yeah.
And it bothered me for a long time till I got deliverance over it. But that shouldn't stop us today from shouting.
Yeah.
Right.
It shouldn't stop the men from shouting.
Yeah.
Right.
It shouldn't stop the women from shouting.
Yeah.
Or the kids from shouting. Yeah. Our youth group ought to be more on fire than it's ever been.
Yeah.
And you can get that way.
Yes.
Here's what it says in Genesis chapter number 49. It says, Jacob's talking to his sons here. I'll read them all so you can know how important Judah is. It says, and Jacob called unto his sons and said, gather yourselves together that I may tell you that which shall befall you in the last days. Gather yourself together here, ye sons of Jacob, and hearken unto Israel your father. Reuben, thou art my firstborn, my might, and the beginning of my strength, the excellency of dignity, the excellency of power. And you read that and you want to be Reuben, don't you?
Yeah.
Until verse 4.
Yeah.
Unstable as water. Thou shalt not excel. Oh, man. No longer do I want to be Reuben. Because thou wentest up to thy father's bed, then defilest thou it. He went up to my couch. Simeon and Levi are brethren. Instruments of cruelty are in their habitations. Man, it's going downhill. Oh, my soul, come now not thou into their secret. Unto their assembly, mine honor, be not thou united. For in their anger they slew a man, and in their self-will they dig down a wall. Cursed be their anger, for it was fierce, and their wrath, for it was cruel. I will divide them in Jacob and scatter them in Israel. Now, we don't want to be like them, do we?
No.
But listen to verse 8. Judah, thou art he whom thy brethren shall praise. Thy hand shall be in the neck of thine enemies. Thy father's children shall bow down before thee. Judah is a lion's whelp. From the prey, my son, thou art gone up. He stooped down, he couched as a lion, and as an old lion, who shall rouse him up? I was watching this video a while back, and it was of a bunch of hyenas harassing a bunch of lionesses. And I don't know how many hyenas there were. The video frame wasn't very big, and it just seemed like there's tons of these hyenas. And they were harassing a bunch of lionesses. That's a 600-pound cat, however big they are. I wouldn't want to mess with one lioness.
Yeah. No.
But here's all these hyenas messing with this lioness. And it was going on pretty good, and they were trying to take the kill that the lionesses had. And then all of a sudden, you see this one hyena kind of look up, and his attention got real focused.
Yeah.
And out of the frame, which we couldn't see at this moment, he started like, his body was twitching like he's about to run. Then all of a sudden, he took off.
Yeah.
And into the frame comes this male lion. And it didn't, I don't know how many hyenas were there. One male lion ran them all off.
Yeah.
They said, we can harass those lionesses, but when that dude shows up, we got to go.
Yeah.
Right. Because he don't play games.
Yeah.
Right.
Those hyenas are no match for a male lion.
Nope.
No match. They are so powerful.
Yeah.
When those male lions get to fighting, it's awesome watching them fight.
Yeah.
But those hyenas were not afraid of the lionesses. They got afraid, though, when that male lion showed up.
Right.
I'm preaching about Judah tonight, and I'm preaching about praise.
Yeah.
It'll get better. No, just stick with me here. Here's what it says about Judah. It says, Judah is a lion's whelp from the prey, my son, thou art gone up. He stooped down and cast his lion. He said that his hand is going to be in the neck of his enemies. Now listen to verse number 10. It says, the scepter shall not depart from Judah.
Right.
The scepter shall not depart from Judah.
Yeah.
This is a promise.
Yeah.
He said, Judah, you're getting a scepter. Now, the meaning of this word scepter, it can mean rod or staff. They all are weapons. That's what you got to understand tonight. That this scepter it's talking about here, it was talking about being a weapon.
Right.
It says, Judah, the scepter, the weapon is never going to depart out of your hands. Now, I got to thinking about this, and I've always thought, well, we know that Judah is praise.
Uh-huh.
And we know that God loves praise.
Right.
Yeah. We know that God loves it when we praise him.
Yeah.
I could read you hundreds of scriptures out of Psalms about praising God and how much God likes it. But I thought, you know what? Everybody knows those scriptures. But I want to read another story real quick in 2 Chronicles, if you can turn there. Are you hearing me tonight?
Yeah.
2 Chronicles, chapter number 13. I know the men are like, quit picking on us. Don't worry, I'm in your crowd too.
Just preach the truth.
2 Chronicles chapter number 13, verse 1 says, now in the 18th year of King Jeroboam began Abijah to reign over Judah. He reigned 3 years in Jerusalem. His mother's name also was Micaiah, the daughter of Uriel of Gibeah. And there was war between Abijah and Jeroboam. And Abijah set the battle in array with the army of valiant men of war, even 400,000 chosen men. Jeroboam also set the battle in array against him with 800,000 chosen men, twice as much, being mighty men of valor. 800,000 chosen men, mighty men of valor, against 400 chosen men. Who do you think is going to win the fight? It says, and Abijah stood up upon the Mount Zemaraim, which is in the Mount Ephraim, and said, hear me, thou Jeroboam, and all Israel. Ought ye not to know that the Lord God of Israel gave the kingdom over Israel to David forever, even to him and to his sons by a covenant of salt? Yet Jeroboam, the son of Nebat, the servant of Solomon, the son of David, is risen up and hath rebelled against his Lord. He said, you're messed up, Jeroboam.
Mm-hmm.
And there are gathered unto him vain men, the children of Belial, the children of the devil.
Mm-hmm.
and have strengthened themselves against Rehoboam, the son of Solomon, when Rehoboam was young and tenderhearted and could not withstand them. And now ye think to withstand the kingdom of the Lord in the hand of the sons of David? He's trying to talk him out of fighting with him.
Yeah.
He's saying, listen here. Now, I was thinking about this and I thought, if they outnumbered me, I would want to be talking to them and trying to get them not to fight too.
Yeah.
That's what I was thinking after this story. I was thinking, but here they are. There's twice as many of them as us. We know they're mighty men. I recognize some of them. Let's just talk about them. Let's not fight.
Yeah.
And ye be a great multitude, and there are with you golden calves, which Jeroboam made for you for gods. Made you for gods. Have ye not cast out the priests of the Lord and the sons of Aaron and the Levites, and have made you priests after the manner of the nations of other lands, so that whosoever cometh to consecrate himself with a young bullock and seven rams, the same may be a priest of them that are no gods? He's saying, you did a bunch of stuff that you weren't supposed to do.
Yep.
But as for us, here's what he said. The Lord is our God, and we have not forsaken him. Now, let me just tell you this. When you get what I'm about to preach, you ought to stand up on your feet.
Yeah.
Okay? You ought to get out of your car and stand up on your feet when you start to get what I'm going to preach. He says, but as for us, the Lord is our God, and we have not forsaken him.
Yeah.
And the priests which minister unto the Lord are the sons of Aaron, and the Levites wait upon their business. And they burn unto the Lord every morning and every evening burnt sacrifices and sweet incense. The shewbread also they set. Hey, we're still doing it the same way we've always done it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
For we keep the charge of the Lord our God, but ye have forsaken him. And behold, I love this. God himself is with us for our captain.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's saying, listen here, if I was you, I would turn around and go home.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because the Lord himself is our captain.
Right.
That should be enough right there to send anybody packing.
Right.
If you know anything about the God of Israel, and it would send anything. They know what God's done.
Yeah.
Right.
They've seen the miracles God has performed.
Yeah.
He said God himself is our captain.
Yeah.
And his priests with the sounding trumpets to cry alarm against you, O children of Israel. Fight ye not against the Lord God of your fathers, for ye shall not prosper.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He said, you're not thinking here.
Uh-huh.
Right.
Yeah.
Let me wake you up here. You're not using your head.
Yeah.
Because
right.
We got God on our side. We may be outnumbered.
Yeah.
You might have messed up already.
Mm-hmm.
You might have fell into something and you think that you're a mess.
Right.
That's what the devil wants you to think.
Right.
He wants you to get all messed up in your head and think that you have no way to turn, no way out.
Yeah.
That you're just stuck where you're at. You'll never be a preacher. You'll never be a singer. You'll never be an altar worker because you're messed up.
Yeah.
That's what the devil wants you to think.
That's right.
Okay? Here's what it says in verse 13. But Jeroboam caused an ambush to come out behind him. Uh-oh. Jeroboam's smart. Says he caused an ambush to come about behind them so that they were before Judah. And the ambushment was behind them. So here is praise.
Yeah.
It's got the enemy in front of them.
Yeah.
And it's got the enemy behind them.
Yeah.
Yeah. Amen.
If you just think about your personal life, you're surrounded.
Yeah.
You got the enemy on every side.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's come against you. He's going to mess with your mind. He preached this morning. It's not a physical fight. If it was a physical fight, man, we'd be all for it.
Yeah.
But it comes down to just simple stuff like just not being offended at one another.
Yeah.
Right.
It comes down to just not like gossiping about each other.
Yeah. That's right.
It comes about not just being a busybody.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. Hey, if you got offense against somebody, you ought to just get rid of it.
Because
the devil's just trying to mess you up.
That's good.
He's trying to stop you from being a soul winner.
Amen.
He's trying to hinder you.
Yeah.
He's trying to mess with your mind.
Yeah.
That's right.
Man, if everything we thought was true, none of us wouldn't have any hope.
Yeah.
That's right.
If everything that comes to my mind that I thought about myself and how much I messed up, oh man, there'd be no hope for me.
Yeah.
See, that's how the devil messes with your mind.
Yes.
He'll tell you you're a no good, dirty, good for nothing. But the thing is you know that there's repentance, and you know that there's an altar, and you know that they're speaking in tongues like he was preaching this morning. You know that there's a place of restoration.
Amen.
Listen to this. So they had the enemy. Praise had the enemy in front of them and behind them. These are the men of Judah. These are the ones that God was their captain. And when Judah looked back, behold, the battle was before and behind. They cried unto the Lord, and the priest sounded with the trumpets. Get this. This is the part I want to focus on. They cried unto the Lord. And the men, here's where I'm going to preach. And the men of Judah gave a shout.
The men of Judah gave
a shout. It wasn't the ladies out there at the fight.
Yeah.
That's right.
It wasn't the children out there at the fight.
Yeah.
When they took their chosen men, when they took their army to fight against the enemy, they took all the men.
Yeah.
That's who was out there going to fight. This is what Judah brought to the fight. They brought the men of Judah. The men of Judah gave a shout, and as the men of Judah shouted, it came to pass that God smote Jeroboam and all Israel before Abijah and Judah. And the children of Israel fled before Judah, and God delivered them into their hand, and Abijah and his people slew them with a great slaughter. So there fell down slain of Israel 500,000 chosen men. All because the men of Judah shouted.
Yeah.
Amen.
They cried. They looked in front of them. There was an enemy. They looked behind them. There was an enemy.
Yeah.
But they cried unto the Lord.
Yeah.
Amen. Now, I know I'm a man in this church. Okay? And we haven't been having church inside the building. We've been having it out here. But I wonder where the shouting went.
Yeah, Jesus. Jesus.
I wonder where the praise went, where the crying out went.
Yeah.
Here's what it says in Psalms. It says, oh, clap your hands, all you people.
Yeah, Jesus.
Shout unto God. Woo! Triumph.
Yeah.
He told you who your enemy was this morning. I'm trying to tell you who's going to fight your enemy. These men were surrounded. They knew they were in trouble, but they also knew who their God was.
Yeah.
They also knew who was commanding their army, who was their captain. All right, man. If you're the head of your household, I want you to come over here. We're about to have church up in here.
Yeah.
Yes.
Can you tell you what? The devil's come against our family so strong.
Praise God.
Amen. Hallelujah.
I'm almost done preaching.
Praise God. Hallelujah.
If you'll be honest with yourself, tonight you'll realize that you've been feeling the enemy fight you. You've been feeling the enemy come against your home. You've been feeling the enemy come against your kids. But here's the deal, is God loves shouting. Here's what the shouting means when you express your emotion. That's what shouting means. And I thought, how come when we come to the parking lot service that there's some people, there's some men here that I used to see get with it in the church building. And I felt it tonight during song service. I felt it this morning during song service. And it's so easy. And man, I tell you what, the devil just hates us. You just might as well deal with the fact he hates us. And he hates men. And he hates godly men. And he hates men that'll stand up and do what God wants them to do. We come to church and we're outside in the parking lot. Men, if you're married and you got kids, you shouldn't be dealing with pride anymore. You shouldn't be worried about what the neighbors are going to say. You shouldn't be worried. Hey, ladies, you ought to get behind your man. That's how it works. And so I thought, here it says the men of Judah shouted unto God. Man. I dealt with pride for a long time. It seems like I preach the same stuff all the time. But the problem is God wants to see you get loose. Brother PJ mentioned it already tonight. There's a lot of retirement going on. There's a lot of men just going, well, I just, you know, get in my lawn chair. We'll get in our truck and we'll go. We'll get ice cream on the way home. But that's not the way it ought to be in God's church. If we come to church, men, we ought to come and have church. If this revival's going to happen, it's going to be because the men of Judah shouted unto God. Here's what it says in Acts. You feel that? You feel that? That devil doesn't like that. You'll run the devil out of your home. You'll run him off of your kids. You can't afford to lose your kids. You can't afford to lose your family. But if you'll shout unto God like it says in the Bible to shout, here's what it says. Let me read one more scripture. I had to find a New Testament scripture. Here's what it says in Acts chapter number 16. I couldn't leave this out when I talk about shouting. It says, and at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed and sang praises unto God, and the prisoners heard them. And suddenly, there was a great earthquake, so that the foundations of the prison were shaken, and immediately, all the doors were opened, and everyone's bands were loosed. So when you start shouting, I'm preaching about the devil's come against your home. He's come against your family. He's come against your kids. If you can't see that fight, then something's messed up. But when we come to church, whether it's online or whether it's out here in the parking lot, there should be no change in our praise. There should be no change in our liberty. You think that God wants his people, he wants his men to stand around and act like they don't got any liberty? No, God doesn't want it that way. He wants you to use the tools that he give you, and that's your voice. That's your shouting. The devil's come against us in great wrath. He's come to fight us. But the problem is, he can't stand a chance against a shouting man. He gave you a voice, and while we sing tonight, you ought to just let loose like you haven't let loose in a long time. I dance, oh, put Satan under my feet. I declare I got victory. I dance, oh, put Satan under my feet. God, and your leader just got up and said, God's our captain, and you looked in front of you, and you looked behind you, and all you saw was enemy. Okay? It says they cried unto the Lord. Do you think they were just like, oh God, I sure wish you'd help us? I tell you what, if you're in a fight for your life, and you realize that if those 800,000 men come over here, it's going to be the biggest fight that we've ever been, and I might not get to go home and see my family. But if you knew God was your captain and you were wanting to get his attention, how would you get his attention? I tell you what, it's going to be a shout like you've never shouted before. It's going to be a sound come out of you like you never had come out of you. You realize the enemy's in front of you. You realize he's behind it. But the thing is that that's going to, how do I say this? Help my emotion. Help how much I put into this. Hey, I'm in the same crowd because I'm a man of this church and I'm a man of God and I want to make it to heaven and we got all this end time stuff going on. But the thing is when we come to church, it shouldn't be that we just stand around. It shouldn't be that we can't hear anybody's voice. There was another story I almost read it tonight when they knew they had the Ark of the Covenant coming to their camp. The Bible says that they shouted so loud that the earth rang. They got so much with it that the parking lot vibrated. And we had to pour more asphalt because there's new cracks in it. That's the shouting I'm talking about. None of this, and I'm talking about getting loose. Your family's got to see you get loose. Your children got to see you get loose. My dad's a good saint's head.
Let's go. what Pentecost looks like. It looks like what you are doing right now. You wonder what they did on the day of Pentecost. It looked just like what's going on over here. Everybody thought they were drunk. Everybody thought they were crazy and filled with me. Why? Hey, when we sing again, if you've been holding back, don't hold back anymore. Hey, if you, is this all right? If you're holding back, I tell you what, that enemy will leave your home tonight. The thing is you gotta give it all you got tonight. You ought to just make up in your mind that when that music starts back up, I'm going to let it go like I've been wanting to for a long time. I'm going to let that emotion come out of me. I'm going to run, jump, shout for the victory.
Oh, that's me.